So let's to continue the next part from this lesson. As you know, we started this lesson in previous class, isn't it?
Yes.
We discussed about so many concepts from this lesson. In that, we discussed about the rise of nationalism. Then, what was the reason for the rise of nationalism? Because everything we discussed in the previous video, and as well as IAC. The establishment of INC, it means Indian National Congress. And before the establishment of INC, many provide organization had established in India because to create awareness among the Indian about freedom movement. Because the main reason here, 1857, then what happened in the year 1857, as we discussed in the previous lesson, is that it? 1857, it means the first war of Indian independence. The first war of Indian independence also by Newton. So, 1857, Railroad had given to lead for Indian freedom movement. After the end of the first war of Indian independence, as a result, British East India Company came to an end in the year 1858. So, in the year 1858, British East India Company came to an end. As a result, Indian administration was handed over to Britain Queen Elizabeth. And later, among the Indian youngsters, the rise of nationalism had created among the youth about Indian freedom movement. Because 1857, Railroad had given to lead for freedom movement. So that many Indian youngsters, they were started to provide about nationalism among the Indians. So that many provide organization. Had established in India before the establishment of INC. And then INC started in the Munche, Bharastu, Sangha Samstagar of Bharata Rutta Hakkari. So as we studied, before the establishment of IAC, many provider organization had established in India. Among them, the Pune Public Sabha, the Hindu Mela, All Indian Association. So these are the provider organization had established in India because to create awareness among the Indians about the freedom movement. And the next one, all these development, because the same period, a newspaper had started across the Indian regional languages. Because of all this development, INC had established in the year 1885. It has been discussed in the previous video. Yes? Yes. Because for all, before the establishment of INC, provide organization had established in India. The late term, INC had established in India in the year 1885. And who was the founder of INC? It is none other than A.O.U. So, A.O.U. was the founder of INC. And the first president of INC, INC means Indian National Congress. Then who was the first president of INC? Yes, it is none other than W.C. Banerjee. So, W.C. Banerjee was the first president of INC. So, INC aimed to create a unity among the Indians. A main aim, national unity as the primary aim of INC. Because INC main intention to get freedom. So, A.O.U. basically he was a British retired civil servant. He met political leaders in the cities like Madras, Bombay and Calcutta. And later on, because a very strong unity was there among the INC leader. And later on, early part of the 19th century, different opinion had created among the INC leader. So before that, 1885, it was very a strong unity among the INC leader because primary unity and national unity. The early part of the 19th century, different opinion had created among the INC leader. As a result, due to their differentiated opinion, also. Because before that they were very strong devotees, and later, due to their differences, opinion had created among the INC leader, so that INC had divided two groups. Which are those groups, students? One, moderates, another, radicals. So, moderates and radicals, these two groups were divided by INC. Because of, due to their different opinions about freedom movement. And the age of moderates, the age of moderates period from 1885, from 1885 to 1905, this era we call the period of moderates. The first traditionally 20 years we call the age of moderates. So moderates leaders, so for example Dadabhai Navroji, M.G. Ranade, Gopal Krishna Gokhale, and as well as Surendranath Banerjee. So these were the prominent leaders of moderates. So here moderates, they believed British administration, they had faith and believed the British rule. Their demanded was going on through prayer and request. Is it possible prayer and request? And then moderates and the Mandha Kamina, Shanta Sabhavana, or Uba, or Yenge and the silent way the Rokhana, prayer and request Mukhama demand the leaders for Bokhana. And the later, moderates were the first members to know the ill effect of British rule, because each and everything Indian wealth, each and everything Indian wealth was going to the England country. So that Dadabhai Navroji had written Dream Theory. So Dream Theory was done by Dadabhai Navroji, and that he explained about Indian wealth. And the later moderates were not they are not up to the mark to get freedom, because they are going on through the prayer and request. As to bear and reach out, like I know Shanta Sabhavana, Prathare Mattu request Molaka freedom Siddhati Antandre, it's highly impossible. And then the next period started, that we call radicals. Radicals nothing but extremes. You wish to Shanta Sabhavana moderates are the opposite radicals. Extremes are the Krantikaran, Tivagami, a very revolutionary person. So radicals, the more prominent members of radicals, the era we call 1905 to 1990, this period we call the age of radicals. Then who are the prominent members of radicals? It is the shortly everything we heard told in every day, Lal Bhal Pal. Lal Bhal Pal was the prominent members of radicals. So you should write full name of them. So Lal Lajpat Rai, Balgangadhar Tilak, and Bipin Chandra Pal, along with them Arvind Ghosh. So these were the prominent member of radicals. Here moderates made the silent prayer and request. They are not up to the mark. So then the political beggars were used by radicals. It means radical called for moderates as a political beggars. And then Rajkiya Bhikshukaru and the Heli, radicals, Yari Heli, moderates in the Heli, Rajkiya Bhikshukaru in the Heli, Tiragami and the radicals, Yari Heli, moderates in the Heli. So these are the concepts we discussed in the previous video. This is one of the recall. And today, I am with the continuing part from this lesson. In today's session, we are going to learn the last part from this lesson, that is division of Bengal and revolutionaries. So these two topics we are going to learn in today's session. So let's start our class with the division of Bengal. Let us discuss now division of Bengal. Then what was the reason for the dividing of Bengal? The Yes, now let us discuss about reason of Bengal. Here, the Bengal reason, one of the most anti-British sentiment in India. It means the anti-British sentiment was dominating the Bengal reason. It was the anti-British protest. And then Bengal reason in the British So, the anti-British sentiment was more dominated the Bengal region. It was against for the British. So that in order to all this development, the British had thought the dividing of Bengal. Main reason here, in the Bengal region, Hindu and Muslims were more strong unity was there in the Bengal region. Basically, Bengal was one of the anti-British activity center. And Bengal Pranta Yenagirte and the British Viruddha Vandha Chattupatike Kendra. And moreover, in a Bengal region, Hindu and Muslims were population more than the Bengal region. It meant a strong unity was there among the Hindu and Muslim in the Bengal region. So that the British had thought the dividing of Bengal. And then Bengal and the Pranta Dali, Hindu and Muslim and Janasankhya Jasti and moreover the Vaggad. So the strong unity was there among the Hindu and Muslim. Because for all this development, British had thought the dividing of Bengal in the name of administration. And then all the Vaggad and the Hegatumari word. ಹೊಡಿಬೇಕು ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿ ಆಡಳಿತದ ಒಂದು ಹೆಸರಿನ ಮೇಲೆ ಬಂಗಾಳ ಪ್ರಾಂತನ ಡಿವೈಡ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಹೋಗ್ತಾರೆ ಅಂಡ್ ಮೇನ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ದ ಮೇನ್ ಪರ್ಸನ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ದ ವೈಸರಾಯ್ ಲಾರ್ಡ್ ಕರ್ಜನ್ ಹ್ಯಾಡ್ ಡಿವೈಡೆಡ್ ಬೆಂಗಾಲ್ ರೀಜನ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಇಯರ್ 1905 ಸೊ ಹಿಯರ್ ಒನ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಕ್ಲಾರಿಫೈ ನೌ ಇನ್ ದ ಬೆಂಗಾಲ್ ರೀಜನ್ ಹೂ ಆರ್ ದ ಮೋರ್ ದೇರ್ ಹಿಂದೂ ಅಂಡ್ ಮುಸ್ಲಿಂ ಅಂಡ್ ಮೋರ್ ಓವರ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರಾಂಗ್ ಯುನಿಟಿ ವಾಸ್ ದೇರ್ ಅಮಾಂಗ್ ದ ಹಿಂದೂ ಅಂಡ್ ಮುಸ್ಲಿಂ And way here, Bengal was one of the anti-British activity center. So that British had thought the dividing of Bengal. Because for all this development, British had thought the dividing of Bengal in the name of administration. And then, when the development was built, it was the worker to the Hindu and Muslim. ಒಂದು ಒಗ್ಗಟ್ಟಿರುತ್ತೆ ಅದು ಹೇಗಾದ್ರೂ ಮಾಡಿ ಡಿವೈಡ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು ಅಂತೇಳಿ ಯಾವ್ದೋ ಒಂದು ಹೆಸರಿನ ಮೇಲೆ ಅವರು ಬೆಂಗಾಲ ಡಿವೈಡ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಆಡಳಿತದ ಒಂದು ಹೆಸರಿನ ಮೇಲೆ ಇನ್ ದ ನೇಮ್ ಆಫ್ ಅಡ್ಮಿನಿಸ್ಟ್ರೇಷನ್ ಬ್ರಿಟಿಷ್ ಹ್ಯಾಡ್ ಡಿವೈಡೆಡ್ ಬೆಂಗಾಲ್ ರೀಜನ್ ಇನ್ ಟೂ ದೆನ್ ಹೂ ಡಿವೈಡೆಡ್ ಬೆಂಗಾಲ್ ರೀಜನ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ನನ್ ಅದರ್ ದೆನ್ ವೈಸರಾಯ್ ಲಾರ್ಡ್ ಕರ್ಜನ್ ಹ್ಯಾಡ್ ಡಿವೈಡೆಡ್ ಬೆಂಗಾಲ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಇಯರ್ 1905 ಹಿಯರ್ Moreover, east part of Bengal had more Muslims and west part of Bengal had more Hindu. And then, east part, and the Pura Bengaladalli yaru jaasti iddare Muslim jaasti iddare and the Paschima Bengaladalli yaru jaasti iddare Hindu iddare. And the main here, the British intention to divide in the religion. Basically, in the name of administration, British had divided Bengal. But reality here, the Bengal had more of a Muslim and Hindus. And then, Bengaladalli, Deru Dharma vannu udibeku anta heli, Bengalannu divide madta hogtare. I think I hope you are understood. And then, basically, the Bengal region was more strong here, Hindu and Muslim. It means, the strong unity was there among the Hindu and Muslim so that British had thought the dividing of Bengal in the name of administration but reality was there andre vastavane bere andre eru dharmana odibeku ante so in reality in the Bengal region Hindu and Muslim were more populated then here east part of Bengal Muslim and the west part of Bengal was the Hindu. And then, Pura Bengaladalli Muslim are jaasti idare and Paschima Bengaladalli yaare Hindu idare. And when Viceroy divided the Bengal region, east part and and the west part. It was completely opposed by INC. When Viceroy Lord Curzon had invaded the Bengal region in the year 1905, it was opposed by INC, Indian National Congress. Yavagya Bengal Eru Martre, Pura Bengal, Pachima Bengal, they have a debate Martre, either Yar opposed Martre and Tandre, the Berala INC. It was opposed by INC. The division of Bengal in 1905 was opposed by INC leader. Still now, the Bengal language, could develop unity among the Hindu and Muslim. Still, the Bengali language could unity among the Hindu and Muslim. And then, when Lord Curzon had divided the Bengal region, the east part and the west part, it was opposed by INC leader. But still, Bengali language could develop unity among the Hindu and Muslim, and as well as, and moreover, in the Bengal region, the Bengal people, they were celebrating the festivals all together. And then they were celebrating all the festivals together, Raksha Bandhana, and as well as cultural festival. So Bengali language could develop a strong unity among Hindu and Muslims, and as well as they were celebrating all the festivals and together Raksha Bandhana and as well as cultural festival. And the region of Bengal resulted in the widespread and protected all over India. So ಬಂಗಾಳದ ವಿಭಜನೆ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಇಡೀ ಭಾರತದಾದ್ಯಂತ ಸ್ಪ್ರೆಡ್ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಬರುತ್ತೆ. ಸೊ ಐಎನ್ಸ್ ಲೀಡರ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಮೋರ್ ರಾಡಿಕಲ್ಸ್ ಮೆಂಬರ್ಸ್ ದೇ ಡಿಸೈಡೆಡ್ ಟು ಬಾಯ್ಕಾಟ್ ಆಲ್ ದ ಗೂಡ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಫಾರಿನರ್ಸ್. ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಯಾವಾಗ ಬಂಗಾಳವನ್ನು ಒಡಿತಾರೆ, ಸೊ ರಾಡಿಕಲ್ಸ್ ದೇ ಡಿಸೈಡೆಡ್ ಟು ಬಾಯ್ಕಾಟ್ ಆಲ್ ದ ಗೂಡ್ಸ್, ಅಂದ್ರೆ ವಿದೇಶಿ ವಸ್ತುಗಳನ್ನ ಬಹಿಷ್ಕಾರ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಹೋಗ್ತಾರೆ. ಸೊ ದ ಡಿವಿಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಬೆಂಗಾಲ್ ಹ್ಯಾಡ್ ಸ್ಪ್ರೆಡ್ all over India. So, and later, the radical members, they were decided to boycott all the goods of foreign. And then, Videshi Vastumana Bhaishkara Madhudu, and as well as it's avoiding institution that encourages, and then, Videshi Samstagana Bhartri Yave Vidave, and Videshi Vastumana Bhaishkara Madhudu Mulaka, Bangharata Vibhajana, on the Virudha Bhartha Hokhari. And the later, because for all these development, the British government withdrew the Bengal division in the year 1911. So, when Lord Curzon had divided Bengal region 1905, it was opposed by INC leader. So, the Bengal region, the division of Bengal had spread all over India, and the radicals and INC leader, they started to boycott all the foreign goods and the foreign institutions who were there in India. It was completely boycotted by the Indian because it was opposed by INC leader. All these development, because for all these development, British government withdrew division of Bengal in the year 1911. ಇವಾಗ ಬಂಗಾಳದ ವಿಭಜನೆ ದೇಶದಾದ್ಯಂತ ಒಂದು ಸ್ಪ್ರೆಡ್ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಬರುತ್ತೆ. ಇವಾಗ ವಿದೇಶಿ ವಸ್ತುಗಳನ್ನ ಬಹಿಷ್ಕಾರ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ, ವಿದೇಶಿ ಸಂಸ್ಥೆಗಳನ್ನ ಬಹಿಷ್ಕಾರ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ. ಈ ಎಲ್ಲಾ ಡೆವಲಪ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಇಂದ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಬ್ರಿಟಿಷ್ ಗವರ್ನಮೆಂಟ್ ಏನ್ ಮಾಡುತ್ತೆ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಬಂಗಾಳದ ವಿಭಜನೆಯನ್ನ ಹಿಂದೆ ತಗೊಳುತ್ತೆ. ಸೊ ಬ್ರಿಟಿಷ್ ಗವರ್ನಮೆಂಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಡ್ ವಿಥ್ಡ್ರಾ ಫ್ರಮ್ ದ ಬೆಂಗಾಲ್ ಡಿವಿಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಬೆಂಗಾಲ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಇಯರ್ 1911. ಸೊ ಡಿವಿಷನ್ ಡಿವೈಡ್ ಆಗಿದೆ ಯಾವಾಗ 1905, ಮತ್ತೆ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಬಂದಾಗಿದೆ ಆದ್ರೆ ಯಾವಾಗ ವಾಪಸ್ ತಗೊಂತ ಹೇಳಿ 1911. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಕಾನ್ಸೆಪ್ಟ್ ದ ಡಿವಿಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಬೆಂಗಾಲ್. ಅಂಡ್ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಫಿಗರ್ ಬಾಲ್ ಗಂಗಾಧರ್ ತಿಲಕ್. ಹೂ ವಾಸ್ ಅ ಪ್ರಾಮಿನೆಂಟ್ ಮೆಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ ಅ ರಾಡಿಕಲ್. ಸೊ ಬಾಲ್ ಗಂಗಾಧರ್ ತಿಲಕ್ ಹ್ಯಾಡ್ ಡಿಕ್ಲೇರ್ಡ್ ಅ ವೆರಿ ಪವರ್ಫುಲ್ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಫಾರ್ ಬ್ರಿಟಿಷ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಆಸ್ ವೆಲ್ ಆಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ಇಂಡಿಯನ್. ದಟ್ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ವಾಸ್ ದ ಮೋಟಿವೇಟ್ ಫಾರ್ ದ ಇಂಡಿಯನ್ಸ್. ಐ ಥಿಂಕ್ ಯು ವುಡ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಹರ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ಎವ್ರಿ ಟೈಮ್ ವೆನ್ ಎವರ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಸೆಲೆಬ್ರೇಟಿಂಗ್ ಇಂಡಿಪೆಂಡೆನ್ಸ್ ಡೇ, ಇಸ್ಂಟ್ ಇಟ್? ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ವಾಸ್ ಗಿವನ್ ಸ್ಟಿಮ್ಯುಲೇಟ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಮೋಟಿವೇಟ್ ಫಾರ್ ಇಂಡಿಯನ್ಸ್. ದ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ನನ್ ಅದರ್ ದೆನ್ ಸ್ವರಾಜ್ ಇಸ್ ಮೈ ಬರ್ತ್ ರೈಟ್, ಐ ವುಡ್ ಡೆಫಿನೆಟ್ಲಿ ಗೆಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಬ್ಯಾಕ್. ದಿಸ್ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ವಾಸ್ ಗಿವನ್ ಬೈ Balganga, the Tilak. I think you would have heard in our time. So Balganga, the Tilak was a prominent member of a radical and he was the main person to oppose the division of Bengal. And he given a statement, had declared a very powerful statement for British and as well for Indian. The statement was stimulate and motivate for the Indians. Avantu ondu helike Bharata Bharatiyaga ondu prachodane agutte freedom bagge. Andre adu ondu motivate inspiration thantu kottare. So swara that is a statement that is Swaraj is my birthright, I will definitely get it back. Swaraj and Ajanma Siddha Haku, Adulam Padate Tirutinandali, Yahi, it is none other than Balgangadhar Tilak. And Balgangadhar Tilak and his member of radicals, their goal to attain complete freedom of the radical. Balgangadhar Tilak Matu, radicals members of Udeshena. ಪೂರ್ಣ ಸ್ವತಂತ್ರ ಬೇಕು ಅನ್ನೋದು ಇಂಟೆನ್ಷನ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ದ ಏಮ್ ದ ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ ಅಟೆಂಪ್ಟ್ ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ ಫ್ರೀಡಮ್, ದಿಸ್ ಏಮ್ ವಾಸ್ ದ ಆಫ್ ರಾಡಿಕಲ್ಸ್. ಅಂದ್ರೆ ರಾಡಿಕಲ್ಸ್ ಮತ್ತು ಬಾಲಗಂಗಾಧರ್ ತಿಲಕ್ ಅವರ ಒಂದು ಮುಖ್ಯ ಉದ್ದೇಶ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಸಂಪೂರ್ಣ ಸ್ವತಂತ್ರ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿ ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ ಫ್ರೀಡಮ್. ದ ಏಮ್ ಟು ಅಟೈನಿಂಗ್ ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ ಫ್ರೀಡಮ್, ದಿಸ್ ಏಮ್ ವಾಸ್ ಆಫ್ radicals. And later they tried to organize the common people in India and they tried to organize the meeting and started to provide awareness among the Indians about the freedom and all. It completely they are providing guidance and everything. And as well as they used to celebrate many festivals to bring unity among the Hindus and Muslims. So they celebrating Ganesha, Shivaji and Durga celebration to organize people because to create a strong unity among the Hindu and Muslim. Andre radicals are yen martare antantandre Ganesha habba, Shivaji festival, Durga festival la celebrate martta hogtare. The main intention here to create a strong unity among the Indian people. And the later on Balgangadhar Tilak had written so many works, among them few works very important here. Then Kesari in the Marathi language and the Maratha in the English language. I think it is getting confused here. So definitely 2 marks can be asked in annual examination. Like the name the works of Balgangadhar Tilak. That is one. Kesari in the Marathi language. Kesari which language is there? Marathi language and Maratha in English language. So these two works were published by Balgangadhar Tilak. Because for all these development, the British government had sent him a prison. Andre it is true on the Maratha in the Balgangadhar Tilak or is true on the festivals to celebrate Maratha. Because for all these development, British government. So sent him a prison andre or a jail hack because of ella chakravartikalana gamanadalli ittukondo. So they were started to boycott foreign goods and everything. Adu videshi vastra bahishkara madodagirli athava Ganesha festival agirli Shivaji festival idra ondu martta idare ante heli British government en madutte antade Balgangadhar Tilak avaru jail hack. In there also, Balgangadhar Tilak had written a famous work, that is Gita Rahasya, in prison. Andre jailalle idkondene ondu work barithe ondu krutina barithare adu yavudu antandre Gita Rahasya. So Gita Rahasya was written by Balgangadhar Tilak. So these two works published by Balgangadhar Tilak only, that is Kesari in the Marathi and Maratha in the English. Because for all these development, British government sent him prison. In there also, so Balgangadhar Tilak had written a work, a very famous work, that is Gita Rahasya. And during the same year, the Muslim League had established in the year 1906. So even they were all development to nadavili because at that time alle enagutte antandre Muslim League was established in the year 1906. So this is the concept, the division of Pengal and as well as our past father Tilak. Next move on, and this is the last concept from this lesson, and that is revolutionaries. And what was the contribution given by the revolutionaries for Indian freedom movement? As we discussed in the previous concept about moderates and radicals. Moderates, radicals, and revolutionaries aim to get the freedom from the British, but that they were thinking the way of strike would change. And what were the contributions and how the revolutionaries had created a violent agony to the British? And who are the prominent revolutionaries in India? What they done for freedom? And so these are all the concepts I now discuss. Here, the revolutionaries dream of attaining complete freedom from the British so that they thought they can send away British from the India by the violent methods. So not non-violence. The moderates, they thought by throw the British prayer and request. But revolutionaries is like aggressive persons. So each and everyone had aim to get freedom, but the way of the thinking style, the way of the about freedom movement, it's completely changed. And the revolutionaries aim attaining complete freedom from the British so that they thought they can send away British from the India, its only method, by the violent methods. So that they established a secret organization, they established a secret association across the country, so that they started to collecting weapons, money, arms across the country, and as well as revolutionaries had given training us. So, revolutionaries aim to get complete freedom, not prayer and request, complete violence method, aggressive persons. Krantikarigalu antandre, avara swabhava hege antandre, rakta kudithiddaru olagade, namma bharatakke swatantra kodbeku antheli. They not non-violent method, they throw only violent method. Stop. It possible only through the violent method, not the non-violence method. So that the revolutionaries started to collect weapons, money, arms, and as well as they given training also. So that they started to create a secret association across the country. And who are the association established by revolutionaries? And few important organized and established in three countries. First, few Lotus and Jagger had established in England. So, Lotus and Jagger had established in England, and as well as Gadda in USA. And one of the revolutionary person had given support in England, it is none other than Arvind Ghosh. I think you would have heard the name in the previous class. Arvind Ghosh was a prominent member of Radical. Here, a secret association had created in three countries. Here, the Lotus and Jagger, these two secret organization had established in England. And in England, one of the radical comes revolutionaries, because many radicals become later on revolutionaries also. So Arvind Ghosh, one of the prominent member of the radical, and later on he became a revolutionary. And he given support for the freedom movement in England. And as well as Gadda had established in USA, United States of America, and in India, a two important secret organization had established in India, for Abhinava Bharata and Anushila Samiti. So Abhinava Bharata and Anushila Samiti, these two organizations had established. namely two organizations had established in England, which are those one, Lotus and Fred, and in USA, Gaga, and in India. And the name of two organizations established in India, one, Abhivadava Bharata and Anushila Samiti. These two secret organizations had established in India. But all the secret organizations aim to attain complete freedom. And the prominent members of the revolutionaries here they Chandrasekhar Azad, Aravind Ghosh, V.D. Savarkar, Ashwini Kumar Dattam, Rajguru, Vishnu Shastri, Raj Bihari Ghosh, Khudiram Ghosh and Bhagat Singh and many others. So these were the prominent revolutionaries in India. V.D. Savarkar, Vinayak Damodar Savarkar, and these were the prominent revolutionaries in India. And as I told now, many radicals became a revolution. Such an example, Aravind Ghosh. So Aravind Ghosh, before he was the member of the radical, and later on he became the revolutionary. So again, once I'm repeating here, the prominent revolutionaries in India. Those are Chandrasekhar Azad, Aravind Ghosh, V.D. Savarkar, it means Vinayak Damodar Savarkar, Ashwini Kumar Dutt, Rajguru, Vishnu Shastri, Raj Bihari, Ghosh, Khudiram Ghosh and Bhagat Singh. So I think in our life we have heard and have written these persons because their contribution was more there for Indian freedom movement, because the revolutionaries aim to attain complete freedom. So later on, the dream of the revolutionaries to bring a complete freedom, but it did not complete. Krantikarigala ondu guri enagittide, purna swatantra sibbeku anta bahalashtu struggle madidre, but it complete agalilla. So the revolutionaries aim, the dream of revolutionaries to bring a complete freedom of India very quickly, but it did not complete. But that they were the foundation of spirit of Indian freedom movement. Their revolutionary spirit had given the spirit and motivation and stimulate for Indian freedom movement. So this is the concept about the revolutionaries, and by this concept and by this topic, today we have completed such a very interesting lesson from the history part, that is freedom movement. So, thank you and have a nice day.